I am not a. I cannot give a lecture. I am a storyteller basically. I will start with a story. This story, blank, almost similar to my mind. Excuse me. Okay. This story has been told many times. This is a very common popular story. This is a story of a divine fruit. It looks like an ordinary mango, but this is a divine fruit. The story starts like this. There is a sage called Narada. He is a chief troublemaker in the Puranas. His aim is to make trouble. So one day he went to Mount Kailas, where Shiva was there, Parvati was there, both his kids were playing. So he thought that this looks like a happy good family. I should make a trouble. So he brought this mango from him and said that one of you kids will get the mango. And as usual, what happens, the siblings started fighting. Then their mother said, hey, why are you fighting? I'll cut it into two and give it to you half. But that will not do, Narada said. Because this is the fruit of knowledge. What is the use of half knowledge? So you will get only the person who will win in a competition, which I say, it's a competitive world. Who wins in the competition, he can have the fruit of knowledge. So the rules of competition were set. Who goes around the world three times and comes first, he will get the mango. Now, Lord Subramanya, the younger son, immediately took off his peacock and zoomed around the world three times. But by the time he came back, his elder brother was already into the last piece of the nut. He was sucking the mango. And Subramanya got wild. This is not fair. I followed all the rules. Then Lord Ganesha said, see, you went around in your world. My world are my parents. I went around them. So I won it. This story, this is not the end of the story if you read Puranas. Unfortunately or fortunately, nowadays, we have a tendency to look mythology in the way in which we want. We stop the story where it is convenient. We praise Lord Ganesha saying that, wow, he has won in the Indian method. One, he has told, which parent doesn't like to hear this? You are my world. So I went around you. He cheated Subramanya. But that doesn't matter. That's the Indian way of working. Somehow we'll do something. Result matters. Third thing, he says that this is an Indian typical Jugaad method, somehow get things done. Don't bother about consequences. Mr. I will come back to the story again after going through my small presentation in my own Jugaad way. Jugaad as such is a recent Indian myth. Nowadays it has got lot of glamour. Because a lot of management gurus, I have attended many seminars, a lot of people come to teach. I'm sorry to say, many people say this story particularly and say, Indians are a special breed. We do things in our own way. So this is something very glorious thing to have. I say, India lost it when we accepted Jugaad as a part of our civilization. Jugaad is an excuse for a civilization that has accepted defeat. Let us see the modern myth which is told about Indians. Myth number one, Indians cannot follow rules. They say that a traffic, typical traffic junction in any city, what not is there in the road? Bullocks, elephants, scooters, cycle, people running from the top of the building, jumping into the road, all sort of things we see. And immediately lot of gurus say, see, this is how Indians are. So in our companies, in corporates, life also, Indians don't follow rules, but it doesn't matter. Somehow we will make things done. But is it so? India has followed, this may not be a good thing or bad thing, I am not arguing. I am just saying that India followed and still follows some of the most complicated rules ever invented. I am talking about caste rules. For more than 2000 years or more, irrespective of regime changes, rise and fall of empires, the caste rules rules designed for who is pure or impure, who should touch who, when, where, how, who can do what, how, when, where. There are so many complicated rules. Who can stand, how near, far, speak, touch, see. Even education, even after all, so many reforms, nothing has changed. I don't know, you just see the matrimonial column, you can find JAT MBA. Do this institute give any MBA like that? Maybe it's from some other college. Brahmin engineer. This kind of things we see. So it is not that Indians cannot follow rules. Indians follow rules when it is convenient. Second myth, India cannot follow process. India, in Indian company, somehow we make things done. So that is, earlier we used to feel ashamed. Now we have got one new set of gurus who says, yeah, this is the Indian way, so this is something we should have. We do everything from our heart. This is how you justify when you do something wrong. This is from my heart. That is the Indian method. You are very emotional people. You have to just see some few of the Bollywood films. You are very emotional people. There is no system or process for us. There is standardization. What is it? We never follow any standardization because we are very innovative, creative people. There is no need for standardization. Is it so? Complicated rituals are followed in every country. In my state, Kerala, there is a revival of all ancient Vedic yajnas. It is fascinating to go and see, watch that. Including the sacrificial altar, it is standardized, and how it was done 3000 years before, 4000 years before, the exact dimensions they keep. That sort of standardization you are following. There is in all rituals and pujas are standardized in the temple. Many people don't observe this. If you see that, there are exact manuals available, rules and process for how each deity has to be prayed. When, with what flower, what offering, how, who should do that. Everything is standardized. These things also have withstood so many invasions, thousands of years of invasions and other things, temple breaking, everything it has withstood. How this system has withstood when a common manual written in our, even for a very sensitive sector like aviation, people are not ready to follow now. I fail to understand. Third myth is Indian stretchable time. We keep stretching the time. Why now? Earlier we used to say it is very bad, we should be like British, they follow the time correctly. My father's generation and all used to say that. Now we have justified this also. Oh, that is because we believe in birth, rebirth, life goes on. Try telling that to your boss when you are late. Sir, I am late because it is all, if we believe in cyclical nature of time, we will understand whether your boss is Indian or not. Who cares about time in such an ancient culture? Is it so? Traditional India is the most time-bound culture. Muhurta for everything. Time kept to the last millisecond. We have Muhurta for birth, Jatakarma, naming ceremony, Vidyarambha, exact time is kept. No, I have not seen anybody going late on that. You may be late for the conference, for the meeting, marriage, even for consummation of marriage, Shanti Muhurta, that also we have got time. So we have a culture as such bound by the time. Third myth is that manuals, we don't have manuals for anything, we don't follow anything. Same thing what I was telling. We do not believe in following the book. We invent, we are creative. We are Indian, we are Jugaad. Here, sir was taking about skills. India has manuals for all aspects of life. I am talking about traditional India. You see a traditional dancer or a traditional tabla player or mridanga player, how he is trained. The way in which he, the skill which is important to him, a more contrasting example will be a weaver weaving a Kanjiviram or a Banaras sari. See the perfection he achieves through the traditional skill imparting method. If you go to Mahabalipuram or Bhubaneswar, there are traditional sculptures, you make it. You just sit, stand and watch and see the perfection in their art. And just look around and see the government building, or any building built by the engineers coming from a modern college. You see the difference in skill imparting. Why traditional skill imparting method is better? I don't know. That might be a question for you, sir. Shilpa Shastra for architecture? Even for language, diction, how to pronounce. See, English, we have made a jugaad of English also. There are 26, I speak in a particular accent as per my convenience, there are 26 or 30 methods of speaking English. But Sanskrit was spoken exactly in the same way. Because even diction was, the skill was important. So you don't find a difference in diction of Sanskrit speaking for a Vedic Nambudri scholar from Kerala or a scholar from Benares. They talk in the same accent, talk in the same way when they talk in Sanskrit. Whereas when you talk English, when you talk Hindi or when we talk anything, we can see the influence of our mother tongue. That means again our skill imparting system, somewhere it has got flawed. In temple architecture, sacrificial altar, perfect standardization is there. In teaching of music, dance, you have to just watch a Kathakali artist or a Kathak artist performing, the kind of skill he brings into that, the kind of perfection he brings into that. There, because nobody has taught him about glorification of jugaad and other things. He has not learned any management, modern neo-myth on management. He follows the traditional method, he can find the difference. Now come the last part. This is the latest fact. Corruption is a part of Indian culture. Indian culture trains one to be correct. I was shocked to hear by one of the speakers making such a statement. The example given was, you give offering to the god. You give a coconut to Ganesha and Ganesha gives blessing as if Ganesha is your copra seller in the village. So it is alright, we get the things done. Now this is from a 10th century Chola inscription. This is an ancient Logaita Tanai. I wish this is past instead of the modern Logaita what you are telling. Every panchayat member, this might have been true for the entire country. This is what inscription we have got. Every panchayat member was selected through votes and draw. The Gram Sabha had the power to veto the rulings of even the king. The meetings were conducted in a dignified manner, and if some member disturbed the meeting, he had to pay a fine of 5 tashu or 5 rupees. Of course, they are not talking anything about pepper sprays. But the term was for 1 year. Incumbent cannot contest election for the next 2 years. Swindling public funds was a crime. Not submitting correct accounts was a bigger crime. To prevent dynastic rule, important, note the point. None of the relatives or the members were allowed to contest election for 5 years. Guilty members were barred for life. Anybody swindling the fund, corrupt members, were barred for life. And now come the juicy part. This is Logayukta on steroids. Not only the swindler of public funds, but his wife, his brother, brother-in-law, his parents, his uncles, his grandfathers and grandmothers on either side, his cousins, his nephews, nieces or any in-laws, including nephew-in-law or niece-in-law, all were barred for life. And this was applied for 3 generations. So you cannot eat cattle food, go to jail and make your wife the chief minister. That was not allowed. And more importantly, the house used to be marked as Gramadrohis. It was the term they used to do. We should use something like Rashtradrohi or Rajyadrohi. We have forgotten what we were. Glorify mediocrity in the name of jugaad. That is what it has become. Before, I am just giving a small examples. You can just look around. You can walk in any town, any city of India and see these kind of examples. 1200 years ago, Badami, Chalukya dynasty built something like this. This is the condition of the same town. This is our government puts the board. This is a board representing that. Even that is not standing straight. 350 years back, This temple was designed like this. The same street looks like this now. This is one thing which we achieved, standardization. This thing. That electric pole. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, all electric poles look like this. None of them are straight. No, streets look like this for a country which invented the first closed drainage. This is how the streets look. These are our sacred rivers. A municipal board for cleanliness. I loved this. We used to honor our great men. These all the four statues looks great, improvised in their own way. There are four statues like this. We used to make the statues of our great men like this. See the perfection in art. Now we make something like this. There are worse examples. We make them like this now. I'll come back to the story of the divine food taking. Actually, the story is not stopped there. The Purana says, Skanda or Kartikeya, he leaves home saying that this is very unfair. This is not the way, this is not the rule of the game. I followed the rule of the game. And he cheated. That's not correct. Then Lord Shiva himself had to go and beg forgiveness of his son. And at that time, Skanda Purana says, Subramanya gives the secret of life, secret of excellence to Shiva. Shiva becomes a student, his son becomes a guru. This is the actual story. We have stopped it at the convenient place and you are propagating that. See, what Subramanya says is, he gives the secret of Om. Om has got more than 1,000 meanings. But one of the meaning of Om is perfection or excellence. Subramanya says, life is all about excellence. There is no shortcut. So it is about the excellence. Once we forget that, we start forgetting the excellence and we start going for shortcuts. Jugaad is nothing but a shortcut. Shortcut, we will reach, this is my words, I have put it in Subramanya's mouth. You will become like Ganesha. Ganesha himself is a Jugaad god. Face is elephant, body is this thing. And Subramanya, it is called as the perfect god. The Puranas itself. Mainly it is because Skanda Purana, it talks like that. But the idea here of this story is that the idea of excellence in life. So we forget this at our peril. So when we impart skills, when we do that, there is something which we had learned from the methods from the ancient India. How these systems still survive. If we forget that, and if we keep telling that we are different and try finding excuses, we will end up having streets and electric poles like this. Thank you.